All right, final round. See if this blue white deck can get the second win that I really feel like it should. It's a collection of powerful spells. It's got some accelerants, removal, card advantage, planeswalkers, upheavals. I still feel a bit foolish about losing that first round. Nope, not going to mulligan this one. It's a little slow. Our opponent's mulliganed, and hopefully this mana will be enough to, keep the game going enough for our planeswalkers to go on. I really feel like Elsbeth Tyrell is the exact kind of right balance of a planeswalker, because it's so mono red. Maybe this slow hand won't give us enough speed time, because it's just not too powerful. It brings you conflict about which one to do. And the ultimate is just the right degree of out of touch. Very good card design. Whereas cards that must attack each turn or cannot block or have hexproof have horrific card design in general. I can understand a certain reason for why they exist, but cards like Nozomi Cutthroat. Was it not Blighted Ancient? Nozomi Cutthroat. You can't really block it. It's unblockable and it can't block. Like, super, super boring card. Just no interaction. Jack up, clever. Blocking, bad. Attacking, almost bad. Maybe we should have bounced the pop there, because I'm probably not going to block this turn. Yeah, that was a mistake. I kind of leveled myself in my thought process. Because I was thinking like, we can... Anyway, should have bounced the pop here so that we could have taken two, win the Tata Maniac attacks. Then we could have dropped Jace, plus one it, taken less damage, and got a block and stayed alive, then traded. But I don't really massively feel like it was the right play to do there. So this is two to activate. Yeah. Just buy us some time here. Luckily, Modo will remember to put the triggers on the stack for me. If he gets the land, then we'll spend his whole turn and guys. And if he doesn't get the land, then we're all right. And the next turn, even though Elsbeth is going to die to this Rift Bolt, the 3/1/1s should buy us some time. Trigger. That's what I've taken to doing live. Just saying the word trigger. Like, I don't feel. A judge is going to say, "You said, I said the word trigger." Oh, yeah, but you didn't indicate which trigger. I'm like, "Well, I said that I was doing a trigger." So I feel like just saying trigger is enough for every and any trigger, and most of them are at the start of your combat step. So, let's put some 1/1 soldiers into play. Plus one Jace. And whilst our opponent can't draw land, our planeswalkers, although one of them is short-lived in this world, should, keep us alive to do something. Upheaval again, not at its best against such a fast red deck in our deck, where we can't massively capitalize. So, and Lantox, not bad, but Lantox hasn't been bad. It's not been especially great. I guess it's just. It's worth having in a deck like this where you don't want to miss land drops. So, for one card, it's almost like a given mulligan, but yet it's good in almost every mulligan hand because you normally land light in those. Obviously, matchups like mono red are not where you really want it to be. I Okay, so Jace is going to go to 1 here. And I get to trade a token for a guy. Elsbeth gets to live. That's cool. Well, no harm plus not plus wanting that one. Don't really want to upheaval here, so let's tidings. Make the land afterwards, decide what we want to do. Maybe not even the marsh flats. Probably I'm going to make one of those sat lands just so we can cast land tax, get more spells out of the way. Gonna attack with one of these creatures, because. Oh, probably should have got the tundra there. In case he gets a land and the Genju wakes up. Remove auto yields. I think I just F6 when I hadn't used Elsbeth's ability, which is a bit weak. Don't really understand why Riftbolt went to Jace and didn't target Elsbeth, but very happy for this mountain to stay elusive for a while. Not that I expect the Surtur to really stay alive long, but nabbing the Blood Knight will be cool because, it means that I can block the Genju of Spires if and when it becomes around, and I'll have to use a burn on the Surtur to get it back, and maybe we can delay that for a turn with Ormond. Where's it going? Tyrell, sure. Just randomly attack planeswalkers alternately. Why not? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7 mana. Soa, suspend, remand. Not a great draw from our opponent here. Meanwhile, one of those games where we kind of seem to really have everything. There's the land. Fortunately, Genji's not really going to do very much now. Just holding off the 1/1. I guess I could have figured that out for a while, but it's nice to play around. I mean, always worth holding off one. Otherwise, it really does, just coming to play and eating a planeswalker. Well, then next time we're going to get loads of tokens from our Elsbeth. I like Sorrow Temptation. I'd like to see it reprinted. I'm very interested to see what the new is it Chains of something or other? The new control, blue-black control magic that where you can you, the guy whose creature gets nicked can discard two cards to get it back, but they draw two cards as well, something like that. Char, what are we targeting? Targeting me? Oh, you're gonna try and redirect it. Oh, let's remand it whilst we've got some mana open. Really, yeah. I would have thought maybe targeted Soa there. Sure, F6. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Let's make and sacrifice this. Yeah, Tundra, why not? Cast this. Blue, 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 white, white. mountain, get rid of Genji forever. Don't see much reason not to cast. Passing for one seems fine. Let's get some more guys in play. Don't need any more cards. Casting the prismatic lens there, yeah. Given a moment's thought, that was too greedy. Power sync for one is not as good as a Force Spoke's not as good as miscalculation at this point. Even though we bounce his land and he's not really done much on two for a while. We can't really counterspell Pyroclasm, for example, if randomly has it in his mono red deck. Don't know, to be honest, why they're still playing the game, but we are in a Swiss queue. Our opponent managed to kill two creatures with one stone because we made a prismatic lens. Love it. So happy that came back to sting us in the ass. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. One mana too little to make an equip. So no idea. That's plus one, minus two. Let's minus two it. Why not? Show him some more cards. Probably take the two pile. Playing Solemn versus Daze. Daze is quite good right now, so quite like to have the Daze. It feels better against him than the other two cards, so yeah. Good split. Gonna take the two cards though. 1, 4, 8, 9, 10. So I can make an equip for the Batterskull. Let's do that. Again, obviously there's absolutely no point risking this losing to a lightning bolt. Not losing, but you know, I just don't feel like he's got the card, so feel like we can aggressively go for the win. Cool. Alright, well that was unfortunate. I probably never really got into that game. On the other hand, what would we like to play for the sideboard? I always feel like Phantasmal Bear is actually going to be fine in this matchup. Don't want land tax. Would like this. Shining Shoal's good, Masticore, Thragtusk, don't really want Cigarda, but it is quite good. So let's take out Power Sync, Daze, Essence Scatter, Remand, Counterspell's not the strongest, Jace is good enough to keep, I think. Upheaval's not great either. Looks like we can bring in Cigarda. Whipcorder wouldn't be bad either. Artilleria West can become this. We can add a forest. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 green, two sources is fine. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Still lots of blue, so we can get one more if we want. Then white, totally free. One too many cards because it's a land. Out. Okay, yeah, that feels alright to me. I mean, oh no, there's the whip. Did I get the whip quarter in? Was that a card? No, whip quarter didn't come in yet, right? Sure, let's go with that.